जाके देख रिकॉर्ड में कौन है, इंसान है कि भगवान।
भगवान को मानते हो
क्या?
शोक और पीड़ा ने इंसान को हर दिशा से घेर लिया है।
उस पे लिखा है कि जंग का वक्त आ गया।
भाई वो ईसा के हरामियों को उनकी कब्र में पहुंचा दिया। अब्दुल लंगूर और वो मादरचोद घासलेट के भाई लोग मोइनुद्दीन बाजील जिया सबको साथ।
गायतोंडे भाई कहाँ आप?
अब जो काम भगवान नहीं कर पाया इंसान करेगा।
अहम ब्रह्मास्मि।
July 6th, 2018 ushered in a new age in the Indian TV industry with Sacred Games, led by Anurag Kashyap and Vikramaditya Motwane. This year we got a second season of the infamous series, and somehow we feel the first season of the blockbuster Netflix series was more sacred than the recent one. In this video, we are going to justify the reasons why we feel so. The character development over both the seasons. Somehow we could feel the characters' souls in season 1. Whether it was Inspector Sartaj Singh or Ganesh Gaitonde's dilemma about saving their precious town of Bombay, we felt their anxiousness. The sheer dedication of Anjali Mathur could be sensed till her last breath. Cuckoo was able to spread her magic in our minds. We shed tears when Subhadra died. Kathekar got the deserving applause when he came home to his wife after a hard day's work to tell her he has done good work after many days. And although it was not mentioned in the series, but Kantabai became Gaitonde's second mother, who guided him in the path of terror and violence that enabled him to rise to the top, where he could say,
"कभी कभी लगता है कि अपुन ही भगवान है."
And Bunty's allegiance to Gaitonde was nothing short of what Kathekar had for Sartaj. The characters were so slowly and steadily developed that even the memories of Gaitonde's parents are still etched in our memory. Fast forwarding to this season, Kusum Devi Yadav, who is portrayed by the talented Amruta Subhash, somehow manages to shed light on the character of the Raw Agent, but the rest of them merely act as props on the set. Megha Singh, as Sartaj's wife, made more of an impact in season 1 without showing her face than she did in season 2, despite being fully present this time. Malcolm Murad does little to do nothing, and yet his dialogue delivery was fabulous.
एक और कुर्बानी का वक्त आ गया है।
Kalki and Ranvir Shorey are very talented actors, but both of them are underused in the series. The characters of Batya Abelman and Shahid Khan needed more screen time, and yet their presence was limited. It is always fabulous to see Pankaj Tripathi doing so much with so little, and somehow this time it felt like he wasn't putting in the required effort. This is an if and a big if, but somehow I feel Nasiruddin Shah would have been more appropriate for the character of Khanna Guruji than Tripathi. The plot development. The first season kicks off with a phone call by Gaitonde to Sartaj, cryptically warning him of a violent plan in store for Mumbai. The gangster then kills himself after setting Singh on a 25-day countdown. The narrative cleaves into two timelines. Singh walks to thwart the impending attack on Mumbai, while a parallel flashback follows Gaitonde's rise and the waxing and waning of his fortunes from crime. Season 1 concluded with Sartaj uncovering an arsenal for a possible nuclear attack. Gaitonde's storyline meanwhile ended with him being ferried out of prison by a group of mysterious abductors. This season, the plot gets more ambitious and somehow fails to land on its feet. In the second season, we find Gaitonde being held captive at sea, somewhere off the coast of Africa. He is forced into teaming up with research and analysis wing operative Kusum and do the intelligence agency's bidding in the interests of national security. Hoping to eventually find his way back to Mumbai, Gaitonde agrees to assist Raw and sets up a new life in Kenya. Equally significant is Gaitonde's evolving relationship with cult leader Guruji, who is introduced in season 1 as the Don's latest mentor and the man who eventually spurred his decline. Sartaj meanwhile joins a special investigation team looking into the threat to Mumbai and tracing links to Islamist terror groups. He however believes that Guruji is equally central to the conspiracy, and all these seems too fast-paced, and somehow only the third season can shed some light on whether all this was necessary or not. Last but not the least, we missed Vikramaditya Motwane. Don't get us wrong, we love Neeraj Ghaywan and we all love Masan, but Motwane almost single-handedly developed season 1. Getting in touch with Netflix and putting together all the actors required, it was Motwane's dream child. Whereas people who are familiar with Kashyap's work process know how unpredictable he is to work with, and Motwane was the exact opposite. Even in this season, Kalki praises Neeraj to be that much organized, but somehow the touch of Motwane was clearly missing from the series. Last but not the least, I must give credit where credit is due. Secret Game season 2 is a tender piece of steak, slow grilled to attain the perfect juiciness and tenderness. Don't you feel jealous when all the superheroes who want to protect the world are protecting countries like the USA? When the aliens come, why don't they ever land in India? I guess Kashyap always felt that, and now he has gifted us an opportunity to visualize a pre-apocalyptic India through his and his team's eyes. Yes, it may have some flaws that can be nitpicked, but I simply loved the brilliant non-linear storytelling that pieced together an extremely complicated plot. It engages the audience, slowly unfolding the mystery and allowing them to connect the dots over the course of 2 seasons. Surely this is the first time something like this has happened for Indian cinema. Thank you, Netflix. So although the season may not be as perfect as its predecessor, yet it is definitely worth the watch.
Game over.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Click on the little bell icon if you want to be notified whenever a new video comes out. Don't forget to share this video with your friends. See you guys in the next video.